The legends speak of an ancient evil known only as Cthulhu. It is said to have come to this earth from beyond the heavens.
Hello! This is my Let's Play of Cthulhu Saves the World. I am Lockhart, and I hope you enjoy this. This looks to be a fun little trip back into more classical RPGs of the age of the late NES, early Super Nintendo. This is a blind playthrough, and this one I think it's a bit more satirical, parody sort of game. I hope to enjoy the moment. I hope you enjoy the moment. So, we're going to start a new game here. Let's not do insane. Let's try normal. Commentary. I think we'll do commentary off.
For countless ages, that unthinkable being known as Cthulhu has lain dormant in his underwater city of Relay. Cthulhu, a being so terrible that his mere presence is enough to drive mere mortals insane. Cthulhu sleeps while the world above goes on oblivious to his presence. Until tonight. Awaken, great Cthulhu! Roar! As Cthulhu emerged from the bay, the world seemed doomed indeed. But wait, what's that? A brave and mysterious stranger has appeared from high to the top yonder cliff with a shiny staff. Using a strange holy power, the mysterious stranger has sealed away Cthulhu's horrible power. His power drained, Cthulhu washes up on the neighboring shore, defeated and dejected, looking somewhat like a deflated jellyfish.
After waiting all this time, to have victory snatched from my grasp by a mere mysterious man is highly frustrating.
Very frustrating.
I must get my powers back, but how?
Luckily for the world, Cthulhu didn't know the one and only way to break the curse and regain his powers. In order to break the curse and regain his powers, he would have to do the unthinkable. He would have to become a true hero. Only by becoming a true hero would his powers return to him.
Wahaha! Foolish narrator! While you were busy explaining the situation to the player, I was eavesdropping because I'm Cthulhu and my eldritch powers can do that. I will not be contained by these four walls. Now I too know the way to regain my powers.
Whoops.
I, Cthulhu, hereby vow to devote my life to becoming a true hero, but only so that I can regain my powers, summon Relay to the surface, and destroy the world, of course.
And thus, a most unlikely hero was born. Welcome to your new life as a wannabe RPG hero. Before we begin, allow me to give you a few pointers.
The great Cthulhu needs no assistance. However, for the benefit of a lowly player who dares control me, I will allow you to continue with your foolish game developer. By giving me the ability to run, I'll finish this silly game in half the time. I'll be able to sell it back to the game store before the trade-in value drops.
Yeah, that's not going to happen. Probably because this is released on Steam, an invisible physical game. Press the S key to bring up your
it's probably this point I should know I did tinker with the controls and customize them just for myself because I like them this way. So they might say otherwise. From here, you can chat with the party, with members of your party, check out your stats, start fights, change your equipment, save your game, or teleport back to cities you visit.
I can save any time. What is this? A first person shooter?
His abilities like the sanity slash combat to make your enemies insane. Same enemies take more damage from attacks, but watch out. New enemies become more dangerous when insane.
There will be no watching out. I shall bestow the gift of insanity upon all.
With a combo count. It's then a powerful combo finishing ability like death blow for massive damage.
You done yet? If it's all right with you, I'd like to actually play this game sometime this year.
Good luck.
Cosmic monstrosities don't need luck. We forge our own destiny, no matter what the cost of humanity.
Myself. Probably a good idea. Don't want Cthulhu to go insane. Status. Cthulhu has a 100 strength, which is 120 unless we do equipment. Oh, there we go. Sword and tunic. So, strength, magic, agility, vitality, will. Next level 2 XP. That sounds pretty easy. Starting at level 3. I never understood why you don't just start level 1 in all these games. That might have been the least. And my techniques are insane strength and death.
Beset by vicious monsters. I shall rescue her and thus become like a true hero.
That would work for a dark person, but you have a lot of evil to atone for. It will take many hero deeds before you are even remotely close to being considered a true hero.
Target!
Yeah, definitely.
That will kill the monsters anyway, just for the sake of violence.
Because everyone loves violence. Approaches. Twice! Combo is 0. And once again, this monster is at normal strength. So what are your power? Does that tell me how much damage it does? Okay, so target. 3 times 1 hit combo. That sounds insane strength.
You will be insane.
So I have a times 3 combo. Ooh, that jumped up. That's 48. That's 10 MP though. Oh well. Yeah. Well, I said. Oh, okay. Oh, so you. Okay, so you recover 4 hit points. And I gain 2 XP to go up. And of course, I level up. So hit points go up, and MP go down. And I get level 4. Each insane enemy gives strength plus 10%. Each insane enemy gives magic plus 10%. Those are techniques, not spells, so I'm going to go with the strength.
Die, foul slime monsters!
That's a pretty cool thing. As Cthulhu defeated the final slime monsters, he turned his gaze to the maiden that he had rescued. Gorgeous! Gorgeous! Gaze upon the mighty Cthulhu. She did not see a crazed octopus-draken man.
You was a man. He was a dragon man. He was a dragon. He was a dragon octopus dragon man. But he was Cthulhu!
Instead, she saw this. Lord, and then just laid it on the floor.
Hero indeed. Did you hear that? Do I count as a true hero yet? Dragon. At this rate, I shall never become a true hero and regain my cosmic powers of destruction.
Oh, I implore you to save me from a gooey death. Pretty jumping on your noble quest.
Do anything besides get attacked by swine monsters.
I have an affinity with the creatures of the sea and call them with her genius Aquaman.
Yes.
Oh, and I have this trident which I use to stab things.
That's more like it.
And above all, I only promise you my wholehearted love and devotion, your great big green hunk of handsomeness.
Yes, the great Cthulhu requires Groupie. You shall do. Strictly rock star relationship.
For now,
now that you have a second party member, you can use the chat command. You can also use multi-character unite techniques in battle. I'm sure he wants to be united. Gain more allies to unlock more unite abilities. Random encounters are now active in this dungeon. This is in the dungeon. This is the beach. After fighting 25 battles in this area,
that is so cool!
If you'd like to fight the element, press the S key and select the fight option. That's a pretty cool thing. So chat.
Is that a live starfish in your hair?
Yes, her name is Penta, isn't she?
A live starfish in your hair. People think I'm disgusting.
Status. So Cthulhu is awesome. My stats just stay the same. Thank you. Let's try something. Same is stunned. Cthulhu performs strike. They're both insane. And they do some good damage. Wow. Whoa! You're weak toward it? That's awesome! Seven!